in anticipation of tomorrow, May 18. May 18 is a significant date for quite a few reasons. First of all, on May 18, Catalina Echeverri was born. And this brought and still is bringing lots of blessings since then. Parish and many of our parishioners. So you are a blessing, Catalina, of all of us and of this place, of this church. So I'm very grateful for you, and we pray today at St. John Paul II that you are sharing your birthday with, may bring a lot of blessing upon you and your family, your loved ones, your friends. Also, maybe 1800 years ago, John Paul II was born. But when he was born, his name was not John Paul II, his name was Carlo Wojtyła. So Carlo Wojtyła was born 100 years ago. He was a great person, great priest, great bishop, great pope, and now is a great saint. This unbelievable personality and shepherd of the church, leader of the Catholic Church for 27 years, one of the longest papacy. And he was also one of the youngest ever being elected to become a pope. He achieved so many different, he broke so many different records. Many people that he touched, many people that he met, people he blessed, all the countries that he visited. I think the only place he didn't go was Antarctica. Other than that, he was everywhere. So the list of his achievements are very long. That's why they call him great pope. Great saint. On the day of his funeral, the crowd gathered at St. Peter's Square was calling San Subito, making him saint right away. So it was like he was a saint even when he was among us. And with all his attributes, I think the most important one is that he was a man of faith, and he was a man of prayer, and he was a man of great spirituality. And this is witnessed by so many people, and myself included. When you are in the presence, you are in the presence of him, there is something about you can feel the goodness of that person. You can feel like a good power is beating out the world. It was very approachable. So I think that's also the first thing that why they elected him the Pope. He was a really strong man of faith. And he had a strong devotion. He prayed the rosary. He carried the rosary with him always and everywhere, whenever he go. So that's why his whole papacy, he made talks to the lawyers, Mary. He dedicated his papacy to Mary. So one more thing. On the last day of his God, nuns, were taking care of him. He told the last words that John Paul II spoke. He said, "I'm happy. Don't cry. Don't mourn." When I heard that first, back in 2005, I recalled the saying that I read somewhere, that no one So that exactly happened in the case of John Paul II. When he died, and there was a million people who came to visit his body in St. Peter's Square and to pay their respect. That never happened before. Many people were crying, but his last words were sad and happy. Another thing that I would like to share is this week on Wednesday, May 13, was Our Lady of Fatima. That was also a date, but back in 1981, John Paul II was assassinated. And he said that he was saved. He knew that, he believed that he was saved by Our Lady of Fatima, and said that one hand was holding a gun and shooting, and another hand was directing the bullet. And he survived the assassination, and was healed well. He went to Fatima to thank Our Lady of Fatima for saving his life. And he brought the bullet that he was shot by, and they embodied the bullet in the crown of Our Lady of Fatima. So even now, there is a bullet that John Paul II was assassinated by, embodied in the crown of Our Lady of Fatima. So that's why he dedicated all his life to Mary. Sure that she was the one who saved him on that May 13th, 1981. Great men, great women, but most of all, great saint. So we are grateful to God for giving us John Paul II to be a shepherd for us today, as we celebrate and remember. We would like to wish you a happy birthday, happy birthday to Catalino, happy birthday to everyone who was celebrating the birthday on the same day when John Paul II May. Now we ask this great saint, John Paul II, to bless us who are present here today, all those who are not able to be with us. May he reach all the families